How do you like your wings?
What's your favorite wing sauce?
Mild.
Mild.
Daytona.
Medium.
Or hot.
Hot, hot, hot.
Extra hot.
The original hot, just like me.
How many wings?
How many wings?
How many wings
can you eat?
Can you eat in 10 minutes?
Are you ready? Are you ready? We are here at the original Hooters in Clearwater, Florida. It is the birthplace of the Hooters concept right here on the very hallowed grounds we're on right now. And it is the final stop of our 12-city tour. And tonight, we're going to find the greatest chicken wing eater of all time. My name is Dave McKay.
And I'm Allie Sattel.
Welcome to the Wing Eating Championship, live from Clearwater, Florida, the original Hooters. And folks, tonight, this is where it began. Right now, you're on hallowed ground, and I can't think of a better place to have a wing eating championship than right here.
I can't think of a better one myself, especially in light of the recent renovation of this flagship store. Stick around, because later on in the show, we will give everyone at home a sneak peek of the renovation.
All right, now, if you notice to your left, gonna throw it to Sam Arena. The Sam Arena, Hooters Calendar Girl and Dream Girl contestant and co-host of this prestigious event. And she has a hula hoop extraordinaire with her. Sam, tell us about Heather Frank.
Thank you, guys. Yes, as you said, I am here with Heather Frank, YouTube sensation and hula hoop expert. And later on in the show, Heather is going to be giving us a demonstration of her talents and perhaps giving us a few hints on just how she keeps those hoops going.
All right. We're going to go back a little history in Hooters. Somebody who used to work at Hooters as a wing shaker, you know, put it in the tub and mix it up with all the sauce, and a person that shucked oysters. Now he's a football analyst and a former professional head coach with us tonight, being escorted by Miss Hooters International, Amanda Jiminy. Give it up for John Gruden. Let's hear it. All right, John, a little bit of history with you and Hooters, huh?
Let's get this show on the road. Let's cut the small talk here. I love Hooters. Let's hear it for Hooters tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Hooters!
Now, didn't you started out as an oyster shucker, and what was the technique?
Well, 1984, Hillsborough Avenue in Tampa. I was one of the first oyster shuckers, wing shakers Hooters ever had. And you want to shake them, you don't want to bruise them. But I am very proud to be a part of this great brand for almost 30 years. Worldwide, Hooters is getting it done.
There you go.
Let's give it up for John Gruden.
Hey ya. I'll be short and sweet. I want to welcome everybody to the Hooters World Wing Eating Championship. It's their first one. Let's hear it for Hooters. Let's make some noise. Hooters! You know, I have coached some big offensive linemen in my past. Big. 330-pounders, guys that were 345. I find them every day till they got down to 330. And I told them to get away from the training table. They could eat, man. They could eat with the best of them. And what we're about to see tonight, I promise you, you have never seen before. Just a round of applause for our competitors, please. Joey the Jaws Chestnut is here tonight. Wait. 68 hot dogs in 10 minutes for Joey. Let's hear that. That's unbelievable. Sonya, the Black Widow Thomas. She ate 46 dozen oysters in 10 minutes. And tonight, this group of contestants will meet the Hooter Chicken Wing. Thank you all for being here tonight and your support of this event. And thank you all for supporting Hooters. Let's have a great time. Thanks a lot.
John Gruden. I feel like I want to talk like him now. And like any other sporting event, you got to have the national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, especially gentlemen, please take your hats off and stand for the national anthem. And of course, we can't do it until the Hooters girls sing. Tonight's national anthem will be done by Danielle Sons, joining us from the Hooters in Irving, Texas.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fights, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled
World Wing Eating Championship is brought to you by Hooters. Bud Light, it's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. And by Pepsi.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have been on a journey here to Clearwater, to the original Hooters. We've gone all over the nation. 12 cities, a baker's dozen, and we are here now to see the greatest eaters in the world practicing the greatest sport known to mankind. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you, are you ready?
I'm gonna be doing a little dancing tonight. I just feel it, ladies. Some of you are feeling a little woozy right now. That's my sexual chemistry. Don't fight it. It's like an Ethernet signal. Some of you guys feeling it too, completely natural. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here. 12 cities. We are here. The greatest eaters in the world, Sonya Thomas, is in the arena now. 100 pounds. And yet her teeth shine like justice. She is only 100 pounds, and yet she can beat all of the men four times her size. She's here for you, lady! But this is not just about sport. We are building a relationship. When we come out the other side, we will be different people. We will be transformed. I'm not talking major transformation, like we're gonna dedicate our lives to charity. Small transformation, like maybe we didn't used to like Nancy Grace. Now we like Nancy Grace, small transformation. We're building a relationship, and a relationship is built on trust and communication. Am I right, darling? trust and communication. We're building a relationship. We're going on a journey to self-discovery, to truth. Selector, hit me something from back home. I'm from Brooklyn. What do you got? Oh, yes. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. Competitive eating is the most basic and fundamental sport. Yeah. I'm from Brooklyn. Don't let this gangster sensibility make you intimidated. Don't let it. Don't. I'm a very nice guy. This is the most difficult of all sports. And yet today, we are graced by angels, ladies and gentlemen. They come from a time when humans like words lived in the air before we were pulled down to the earth by gravity. Heaven itself has rusted through on the bottom, and the angels are among us now. You know of whom I speak, of the Hooters girl. Give me another track. Ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the Hooters girls. Here they come. Oh, woo! Oh, I'm feeling the electricity now. I promised myself this wouldn't happen, but I'm feeling it. Here come the ladies now. Oh, look at them, so lovely. Look at that, that's called the pop. Hip down, knee out. I'm from New York. Look at how lovely they are, am I right? What ambassadress, the ambassadress. Look at them now. Put your hands up, girls, put your hands up. They are going to be helping me here today because this is a job we cannot do alone. A 10-minute all-you-can-eat eating contest featuring the greatest eaters in the world. These are our judges. They will help me bring up the wings. They will help us in so many ways. We are led by their brilliance. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you, and you can go off the stage now. Now, I don't know. Here they are. Look, you're going to see more of them. You're going to see more of them. Let's bring this down, Taylor. Bring it all the way down. First of all, I want to say shout out to the Black Honkies who are nothing short of fantastic. Will you listen to that? So I'm getting ready, and Philip of the Black Honkies comes up, and he gives this fantastic introduction using the word groovalicious, which I don't usually use because I'm not groovalicious. I'm like an aging yuppie in a straw hat kind of situation. It's not good. Can we hear? Are they live? Can I hear? Do you got? Let me see what you got. Let me see what you got. What do you got? Are they coming? Can you get them hot? Bring up Philip up here. I want Philip. I gotta learn a little groovalicious. Is he here? Is Philip here? I don't see Philip. Philip's inside drinking a beer. All right, I like it though. We gotta go out on the road together. All right. All right, well, without Philip, I can't do it. All right. Philip. Philip. All right. Philip, give me a little of that introduction, that groovalicious introduction. Give it. Let's work together, baby. Work with me, baby. Give it to me. Because usually I'm not soul, I'm rap. They call me King Latifah. King Latifah. We love you. Give me that groovalicious intro. Give it.
Everybody make some
for the Black Hawkeyes! ladies and gentlemen, this is how it's gonna go. When I said we're going on a journey, I was telling you the truth. They asked me to come. My name is George Shea. I am chairman of Major League Eating, the world body that governs all stomach-centric sports.
Buffalo's in the house.
Oh, yes. Another chicken wing contest that shall not speak its name tonight. We're gonna go out there. This is what we're gonna do. Stick with me on this. I am an eating savant, a competitive eating savant. I see the truth behind the truth, behind the truth, behind the truth. And I whisper when I wanna make something emphasized for emphasis. Okay, I'm gonna do a very big goosebump producing general introduction, and then we're gonna meet the eaters here today. Who's in the arena? As I said, Sonya the Black Widow Thomas is here. Joey Chestnut is in the arena. I promised myself I wouldn't do this. Now I got myself in my emotional place. It's gonna take me like 45 minutes to an hour to get out. And who else? Crazy Legs Conter! Oh, we have so many. A gentleman from England whose name is Lewis Richard. Ladies and gentlemen, here representing London when the Olympics are there. His chances of winning, almost nothing. His chances of failure, very high. Let me just tell you this. I only like two things. One of two things. Spectacular success or spectacular failure. I don't care which. I think Lewis Richard represents spectacular failure. That's just me. I'm an American. Oh. Oh. Wow. I feel like Nixon up here. Never. There's a very negative vibe coming. Okay. Let's do it. Selector, let's do this. Let's go to the fourth track. This is the big introduction. I'm just gonna let the tension build. They say that competitive eating is the battleground upon which God and Lucifer wage war for men's souls, my friends. Are they right? Then this is a battle for the ages. This is a battle of the titans, that being that is half God and comes to earth only once and only one location, and that is here in Clearwater, Florida, at the original Hooters. Today we will scratch our name on the wall for all future generations to see. So it is written, and so it shall be. Let the contest begin! Shake it off. Shake it off, or you will be emotionally exhausted before we even get to the eating. You have to let it go. Learn to let it go. Are you ready? Let's meet the eater, selector. Give me five. Here come the eaters. From Wichita Falls, Texas, a tamale and burrito and taco eating champion. He is ranked number 25 in the world. He is known as Nasty Nate Villa. He calls himself Nasty Nate. He's Nasty Nate, but you can call him Miss Janet if you're nasty. I just play this song because I like this song. I play this song when I brush my teeth. It makes brushing your teeth very important. From Seattle, Washington, where the pure sun slants into the earth, he is the fry bread and spot shrimp eating champion of the world. 6'4" tall, 210 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, let me hear it for Eric the Red Denmark! Oh yeah, that's right. Daddy's home. Suck it to me. Ladies and gentlemen, a rib and potato wedge eating champion from Chicago, Illinois. He is ranked number 10 in the world and recently began Glutton Force 5, a food truck that serves pork shoulder in a clear plastic cup. He's the innovation behind that. Let me hear it for the great Gravy Bro! I ain't got no money. £4.5 of catfish. 48 Maturano's meatballs. 300 crawfish. 37 dozen oysters, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, let me hear it for the man from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Adrian Morgan! He was first seen standing at the edge of the shore between the ancient marks of the high and low tide, a place that is neither land nor sea. And as the blue light of morning filtered through the darkness, it revealed a man who has been to the beyond and who has returned with the secrets of life and death. Because he was buried alive under 60 cubic feet of popcorn, and he ate his way out to survival. And now they call him the David Blaine of the bowel, the evil Knievel of the alimentary canal. They call him the Houdini of cuisine, Crazy Legs Conte! The sweet corn eating champion of the world. The pancake breakfast eating champion of the world. He's a Buffalo Soldier. His mother fell victim to unscrupulous mortgage lenders, and if she doesn't come up with 29,000 pounds by August 6th, she will lose her home. And so he put aside his own dreams of helping environmentally endangered animals to go out on the circuit and raise the money to save his mom. Or so he imagines if anyone ever were to write a movie of his life, because his mom actually lives in a condo she owns outright with her sister in London. But it's the thought that counts, and I will always root for a man who loves his mom. From London, England, let me hear it for Louis Richards! He grew up on the streets of Mumbai to become a competitive eater. But he says he is actually an exotic pet owner because his esophagus is an anaconda that strangles the life from the small animals he feeds it. He is called the chicken chewer from the Mumbai sewer. He is from The Daily Show with Jon Stewart. He calls himself the Muslim muncher. I call him Asif Manzi! Show me that Asif! Show me that Asif! Asif Manzi. He said to me before we began, he said, we are at war with the chickens, and this is a war in which there will be casualties. Today is a day chickens will die. Start over. Start over, Taylor. It was halfway on her way to a new world record of 13.4 pounds of cranberry sauce when I looked at her. Her fingers were congealed in red, her shirt stained in the color of a cheap vampire movie blood fest. And yet she maintained elegance that was unbelievable. And I realized she would always be a lovely woman, even when she's eating 22 pepperoni rolls, 33 hot dogs and buns, 219 wontons, the lovely Juliet Lee. She has a secret garden. It's her heart. Her secret garden is her heart. In her heart are two rooms. Look at how lovely. Look at that tummy. Oh my good gracious. In her heart are two rooms, ladies and gentlemen. One is filled with fellowship, goodwill, and caring. The other, some storage, a treadmill, some books, nothing. Nothing but. Look at that figure. 105 pounds. Unbelievable. To this day, he remembers the words of his grandma when she compared his thighs to two salt hams left to soak too long in a tub of their own brine. He winces when he recalls his high school football coach speculating whether his favorite words in the English language were meatloaf and sandwich or resting and heart rate. But no one mocks him anymore, my friends. Not after he adopted a hip-hop moniker and went on a streak of 9 championships. He is the chili spaghetti eating champion of the world. And you can refer to him as the notorious B.O.B. Bob Chow! Of chili spaghetti. It's just good common sense. 10 minutes. You know how much time that frees up for other things, cleaning the garage? Okay, I'm glad I missed that. Now you're getting to the power, my friend. When Bob is at the table, you know that. From Chicago, Illinois, ranked number 2 in the world, 39 world records. He is the cheesesteak and pepperoni roll and gyro and moon pie and grits and ice cream and jalapeno eating pepper champion of the world. 295 jalapenos. Give it up for my man, Patrick Bertoletti. Who knows what that means? Once in every 10 generations, a hero rises to lead a broken nation to victory. And broken it is in places. and some of you are broken. And you would kneel at the side of the road to be covered in the dust of your enemy's horses. And you would choke and cough, and you would chew as if on gravel. And you would smile the broken smile of supplication, but not this man. He will never kneel. He will stand always, and he will cast you in his shadow. Because the rock on which he stands is not a rock. It is the United States of America. And he is the asparagus eating champion of the world. He is the chili eating champion of the world, the corned beef eating champion of the world. And he is the Nathan's famous hot dog eating champion of the world. Joey Chestnut. Avert your eyes, the champion is here! Look away! Look away! Bring it down just a little, Taylor. Joey, the undisputed champion of the world, a great American known to all. But chicken wings are your bugaboo. Chicken wings have been such a difficult food for you. Sonya Thomas weighs only 100 pounds, and yet she has beaten Joey two times running in chicken wings. This is the challenge against you, which you will measure yourself as a man. Do we have a victory here today, Joey?
I have a feeling Clearwater is going to push me to victory. I'm doing it.
Victory for Joey! Victory for Joey!